when you cry, be sure to dry your eyes, 'cause better days are sure to come. And when you smile, be sure to smile wide.
And don't let them adventurous. Crazy.
Stressful.
The experience was amazing.
Very challenging.
Amazing.
Hard.
Yeah.
Yes.
Tough.
Roller coaster.
Hard.
There's a lot of team building and bonding that allowed me to learn the skills that I needed to a lot easier.
Good evening to you all. My name is Lisa Lefko, and I serve as the resident deacon at Cornerstone United Methodist Church and as the CEO of Habitat for Humanity in Collier County. I can't tell you what an honor it is to be invited to be a part of this celebration with you this evening. This is truly an historic moment as you enter into the front line of your profession in the midst of a global pandemic. As I've done a little research on the pinning ceremony, I've learned that this is truly a sacred moment. For some, it may be as important or more memorable than your graduation. Historically, the pinning ceremony goes back before Florence Nightingale was pinned by Queen Victoria for her service to the military during the Crimean War, way back to the 1200s, and the monks of the Knights Hospitaller who cared for the injured of the Crusades. These early caregivers were awarded a pin of the Maltese Cross, thought to be the first badge given for nursing. For many, it is our faith that compels us to care for one another. And so it is appropriate for us to begin our celebration of this milestone moment with a word of prayer. Often when we pray, we close our eyes and we bow our heads to better focus on our communication with the Creator. But tonight, I invite you to enter into an active prayer. You may want to keep your eyes open. You may want to touch your head, your eyes, your lips, your heart, hands and feet along with me. Or you may choose to sit quietly and allow these words to wash over you. In any event, won't you join your hearts with mine in a spirit of prayer? Almighty God, on this day as we celebrate this rite of passage, we ask you to be present with us, to help us feel you in our midst as we turn this new page and look into the next chapter of our lives that lies ahead. Creator God, you have led us through this journey of education, and we are grateful for the many remarkable moments that we have shared, for friendships that have been formed and lessons that have been learned, some easy and others through a series of hard knocks, for the ways that the world has opened up to us, and for the tug that remains on our hearts to care for those who suffer. Lord, today, as we touch our heads, we are grateful for the gift of our minds. You have given us sharp intellect, and we pray that we might continue to actively absorb the lessons ahead of us, gained through experience and transformed into wisdom. As we touch our eyes, we thank you for the gift of sight and insight. We pray that we might continue to carefully assess and evaluate every new situation with the gift of vision. We pray too that you would bless us with your vision to be able to see beyond symptoms to the genesis of disease and unease. Enable us to peer into another's eyes and to see into the depths of their soul and to bring them your peace and healing. Lord, as we touch our lips, we thank you for the gift of language. May we always be slow to speak and quick to listen, knowing that the power of our words will impact others deeply. Wrap our words in your relentless love that lives might be restored through our acts of compassion and presence. Lord, as we lay our hands upon our hearts, we're grateful for the miracle of life itself, You have knit our bodies together, enlivened by the beatings of our hearts. Lord, may our hearts always be synchronized with yours, with every breath. May we experience your recreation and be strengthened to share the burdens of our brothers and sisters. As we touch our hands, Lord, we're aware that you have called us to use them to perform intricate procedures and to lift heavy loads. May our hands be agents of healing, providing a gentle touch, a caring guide, and a strong hold for all who need. And finally, as we reach to our feet, we remember the words of the prophet Isaiah, who said, "How beautiful are the feet of those who carry the good news." Lord, bless our feet that though tired and weary, we might find strength to walk another mile to care. Make us agile and nimble to forge a path prone to pitfalls. Guide us to the places and the people that are waiting for us to bring hope. Lord, in this moment, we offer ourselves to you, grateful for the inspiration of those such as the Knights Hospitaller, Florence Nightingale, Earl and Thelma Hodges, the faculty and community here at Hodges, and our supportive circles. We're humbled to be nurses and to care for your children. For it is in your many names that we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Lefko. Dr. Ward, nursing faculty, special guests, Thelma Hodges, the 2020 graduating class, and their family and friends. Good evening and welcome to our nursing pinning ceremony. Just as our nursing students have worked very hard to reach this goal, so have our faculty and staff worked equally hard to build what I believe is truly an exceptional BSN program. Nurses are special and gifted people, and nursing itself is both a science and an art. It's a science in that a nurse needs to know the anatomy and physiology of the human body, but he or she also needs to know biology and pharmacology and math and enough psychology to successfully deal with the kind of irascible patient that I know that I can be. The art of nursing is reflected in the tough love brought to the craft, along with the understanding of patients' emotional and spiritual needs in order to render compassionate care for both the patient and his or her loved ones. More importantly, they must be able to do this day in and day out while remembering to take care of their own mental and physical health and well-being. And that's why I chose to become a university president instead of a nurse. It's by far and away an easier road. We are fortunate to have a wonderful example of that caring and compassion in Thelma Hodges, who chose to be a nurse and was more than a little instrumental in Hodges University's decision to start the BSN program. This is a celebration for our nursing graduates, so please join me in welcoming our special guest speaker, Dr. Anne Marie Morisseau.
Welcome, my future super nurses. I was hoping to see all your smiling faces again, but we'll have to do with this video instead. When I was first told that you selected me to be your keynote speaker, I felt so honored as well as humbled. This was not what I had expected. Then I realized that I had to write a speech, and the anxiety set in. I guess this is your revenge for all of my exams and quizzes during your first two semesters where you experienced test anxiety. Thank you again. I know this pandemic has not only affected your nursing curriculum and your experience as a nursing student here at Hodges University, but also your pinning ceremony, which I am deeply sorry for. But thankfully, we can celebrate this special day in somewhat of an informal setting. First of all, I want to thank your family and loved ones who deserve a round of applause for supporting and encouraging you through the countless hours of reading, studying, assignment completion, and clinical hours, as well as missing you during your absence over the last four semesters. So we can give them a silent round of applause. I would also like to thank the Hodges nursing faculty for assisting you in completing your BSN degree and passing on their wealth of knowledge to you. So they deserve a round of applause as well. I remember when we first met during health assessment. Do you remember? It seems so long ago. You were all so eager to learn and just starting to perform basic nursing skills. I remember one student nurse, I will not mention her name, who was trying to listen for carotid cough sounds while performing her first manual blood pressure measurement on her lab partner. She looked at me and said, "I can't hear anything." The stethoscope was in her ears backwards. Now, these nursing skills, such as the proper positioning of a stethoscope in the ears, are second nature. I also recall your excitement the first time each of you looked at your lab partner's tympanic membrane with an otoscope. And to think you didn't even know what a tympanic membrane was when you first started. Think of all the knowledge you have gained over the past four semesters that you did not possess when we first met. I also recollect your facial expressions and mannerisms when taking my quizzes and exams, the frowns, the furrowed brows, the grimaces, the foot tapping, the pen biting, the mouthing of words as you read the question over and over again, bilateral pupillary dilation of 7 to 8 millimeters. Aren't you glad that this is over and done with, except for the mother of all nursing exams, the NCLEX? I would bet you thought graduation day would never come. The countless hours of studying, the lack of sleep, the seemingly endless VSIM, ATI, and DocuCare assignments, the paper writing and the PowerPoint presentations. However, all your hard work has finally paid off, and you are ready to drop the title student nurse and claim your new title, BSN graduate, and soon registered nurse. Class of 2020, you are ready to begin your journey as a registered nurse. As a nurse, you will have so many options and opportunities available to you. You can be the nurse who holds an infant as he takes his first breath in the delivery room. Or you can be the nurse sitting at your patient's bedside, holding her hand as she draws her last breath because she has no family to mourn her. You can be the nurse who cries with your patient after she learns that she has terminal cancer. Or you can be the nurse who rejoices with your patient after he takes his first steps after a devastating back injury following a motor vehicle accident. You can be the nurse who inspires others after becoming a nurse leader. Or you can be the nurse who passes on the knowledge you have learned to other nursing students, just like the nursing faculty here at Hodges University. I am sorry to inform you that the learning does not cease just because you are graduating today. Nursing requires lifelong learning. Sorry, it's too late to change your mind now. Remember, nursing is not a job. Nursing is a career, and it's the most rewarding career of them all. Nursing is a calling, a noble calling, and a noble profession. It is caring and the compassion for others. You will see individuals at their best and at their worst. They will be at their most vulnerable point in their life and depend on you, the nurse, who they will trust with their lives. Did you know that the nursing profession was voted number one in the Gallup's Most Honors and Ethical Professions poll in 2019? Did you also know that this was the 18th consecutive year that the nursing profession was voted number one? Beneficence, veracity, fidelity, justice, do all these terms sound familiar? Remember the meaning of these concepts and abide by them from this day forward. Class of 2020, you are graduating during a special time as 2020 was designated as the Year of the Nurse by the World Health Organization in celebration of the 200th birth anniversary of Florence Nightingale, the founder of modern nursing. You are also graduating during an uncertain time, during a pandemic, where much is unknown about the virus SARS-CoV-2 and the disease COVID-19 that it causes. However, as future nurses, you will be able to adapt to the challenges that this pandemic has presented just as you adjusted to the changes made to the nursing curriculum due to social distancing. And finally, there are so many different nursing career paths that you may choose. So find your passion, travel down the path that is most satisfying to you, and become the super nurse that I imagined you would be. Congratulations, BSN class of 2020.
Thank you for joining us this evening to celebrate our Hodges University Baccalaureate Nursing graduates' amazing achievement. These new nurses are the first graduates of our BSN program since renamed the Thelma T. Hodges Nursing Program, and the second graduation class in the new decade celebrating the 200th anniversary of Florence Nightingale's birthday. August was the month of her passing on August 13, 1910. The World Health Organization has recognized 2020 as the year of the nurse and midwife, and so this is a significant year for our new nursing graduates and our nursing profession. It is not without coincidence that a year of COVID-19 would be on Florence Nightingale's commemorative year of nursing, as she brought the awareness and importance of hygiene and infection control in the 1800s to the medical forefront. Nurses have been notably heroic throughout this unprecedented pandemic. The year of 2020 also holds the significance of the year the Institute of Medicine's Future of Nursing Report of 2010 recommended a higher level of education of the entry nurse and proposed an 80% increase in baccalaureate-prepared nurses. Due to the aging and increased longevity of a diverse population and associated health disparities, advancing technology, and an evolving healthcare system, the BSN-prepared nurse is well-positioned to lead the change and advance health in a number of settings by assuming various significant roles. Most significantly, 2020 represents the lens of clear and accurate vision. The trials and tribulations of the year 2020 has brought to nursing and our nursing students a lesson in courage and resilience. The opportunity to embrace a new vision for academic and clinical nursing practice with the new nursing knowledge acquired is in the future ahead for each of our new BSN nurse graduates. The nursing pinning ceremony is steeped in tradition. It signifies a rite of passage from being a nursing student to an honorable member of the nursing profession. The nursing pin, the lighting of the lamps, and the nursing pledge and nursing cap, although no longer required as part of the nursing uniform, symbolizes the goal of the nurse for providing service to those in need. We are proud of our Hodges BSN nursing graduates and applaud their transition into the most trusted profession of nursing. I would like to present the Thelma Hodges Award of Excellence. This award is presented to one of our graduates for outstanding academic achievement. The student earned the highest GPA in this nursing class. Thelma Hodges Award of Excellence goes to Udiel Vera Gonzalez. I'm also proud to present the Clinical Award of Excellence. This award recognizes a student who has exceeded the clinical expectations and sought new learning opportunities. The student also reflects the qualities of a professional nurse. The Clinical Award of Excellence goes to Catherine Guzman Guardia Rodriguez.
There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning and some dark and cold. Go light your world.
I accomplished my goal, which seems so far away now, but I want to be an OR nurse.
I'm keeping myself open. I'd like to have the experience and the kind of the baseline that we've been taught of maybe working in medical surg. But I've always loved the OR, so I kind of have my vision there.
I'm aiming to be a CRNA, but for that I need experience and I need to be on the floor and I need to get ready for more study.
Intensive care is what I want to go for, and then get a master's degree. We'll see what happens.
I would like to go into the ICU. That's like my main goal. And then after I get some experience, I'd like to head over to either trauma or travel nursing.
Be able to get into the hospital and hopefully be able to impact a lot of lives positively.
I want to become a pediatric nurse because I love working with kids. I've been working with kids for years. I don't know, we'll see from there what happens.
I would like to go work in an ICU or an NICU with children who are in need of intensive care.
I want to get experience on the floor first. I want to get a year and then I want to continue my education. I want to do my nurse practitioner.
After graduation, I'm going to sit and take my NCLEX and hopefully one day do my MSA. Let's just go for a master's degree after that.
I think I'm going to work now for a time, and then I want to keep studying, do my master's degree.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I'm very proud of all of you for graduating from the Thelma T. Hodges Nursing Program at Hodges University. I know you will all succeed in life. There are so many more opportunities at this time than there were when I practiced medicine 50 years ago. And I know you will all be successful in whatever you decide. Congratulations and good luck to all.